Now, Infertility Awareness Week on Eyewitness News, brought to you by the Center for Advanced Reproductive Services.
This week is National Infertility Awareness Week. Many couples wanting to start a family struggle to get pregnant.
But there are some simple things you can do at home to boost your chances of having a baby.
Channel 3's Irene O'Connor tells us more.
If starting a family is in your future, tip number one, quit smoking.
It's been estimated that smoking, per se, accounts for about 15% of all infertility. It's a pretty significant factor. It's just toxic to us.
Dr. Daniel Groh is a lead physician at the Center for Advanced Reproductive Services. The first thing he tells all of his patients, both men and women, is to kick the habit.
We know that in men it can affect sperm counts and sperm motility and probably sperm shape. And in women, we know that smokers have earlier menopause than non-smokers, perhaps by 4 years.
Tip number two, get more vitamin D.
Vitamin D supports overall health, but it also supports reproductive health and natural fertility.
Amy Chokshi is a certified health coach at the center. She tells us the best way to get vitamin D is from sunlight, but it's also found in fatty fish like salmon and tuna, and supplements work well too.
I think vitamin D supplementation is great for overall health for most everyone. It's probably my top recommended vitamin to take when it comes to overall health and fertility.
Now to tip number three, be at a healthy weight.
You know, being too thin or too thick, if you will, or too heavy, adversely affects fertility in a meaningful way.
And exercise is an important part.
30 minutes of exercise, I wish I could give a prescription for that to every single patient because it changes one's life and it can improve fertility and make so many things in life better.
Irene O'Connor, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
And you can get more information on the Center for Advanced Reproductive Services right on our website. And getting underway at 5:30, you can chat live with a fertility doctor from the UConn Health Center. Just head to our website to ask any questions you might have.